classy. That's what we are.
No, I felt like that was a challenge.
But I will not accept your challenge at this moment. Perhaps another time. Hey guys, I'm Christy McKay. I am going back home next weekend. I'm going back home next weekend to host a benefit for a friend of mine. He's turning 50 and he's having a big, big shindig for a charity. And from a real small town. It's the kind of town where people have bumper nuts. You know what bumper nuts are?
Sadly.
Yeah. Yeah, you know that ball sack on the back of your truck? Or vehicle, does not have to be a truck.
Does not.
Did you? You know, I wonder if a lady has bumper nuts. Did you ever put them in your drawers? Just to see what it's like to carry those things around?
I thought about it.
Yeah, see? If you can dig them up, try it. Let us know. But did you ever wonder, you know, here's a lady getting the bumper nuts. Did you ever wonder, hey, how come there's nothing like that for the ladies? How come there's not like bumper puss?
That's right.
Yeah, bumper badge. I'll tell you why. Because those dicks that drive their bumper nuts would just keep ramming that bumper puss. Insurance nightmare. I think that's actually where Minis came from. I'm not sure. Mini Coopers. So yeah, my friend, turning 50. 50's a milestone. 50's not what it used to be. It's a milestone. That's a big thing. Okay? 50 is actually kind of an exclusive thing. It's like when you turn 50, you're in this exclusive club. You can't pay money to get in this club. You can't talk your way into it. All you really have to do, quite frankly, is just keep breathing. But you gotta breathe for 50 years. Not everybody can do that. I turned 50 this year myself, so I'm going to be giving my friend a little bit of advice. Because, you know, you gotta share, right? You gotta share the things that I've learned in my 50 years. I know everybody's not like Garrett, you know, everybody, you always gotta worry about money. Especially, I'm sure all of us here, we're poor artists, okay? I just said I'm 50 and, you know, yeah. Look at me here. Yeah, so I have to worry about saving money as well, okay? And I'd like to give all of you guys some of my money saving tips. First one, all right, the southern hemisphere, very delicate. Don't get that cheap thin toilet paper, okay? Get the cheap wet wipes if you want to, but not the cheap toilet, wet wipes. Spend a little extra cash on the wet wipes. Q-tips, splurge for brand name, okay? Nothing worse than that plastic breaking off right in there. Gotta get your tweezers. If you don't have a friend, you gotta get those tweezers to get in there. It's like, oh my God, what's gonna happen? I know you guys are probably gonna say, oh, this is what she's gonna come up with. Oh, spend money on the brand name condoms. Or the brand name pregnancy test. No. No. What you really need to save your money for is a very good vacuum cleaner, like a Dyson. A sharp stick and a vacuum cleaner. Don't have to worry about those cheap condoms. You're welcome. I can tell you're gonna listen. Pay attention. I'm a single lady at 50, and there are certain things, you know, I'm single, you gotta be fearless now, okay? I'm single. If we go on a second date, I am breaking the fart barrier. That's all there is to it. Because, you know, I'm going to tell you guys, because you don't know where I grew up. I grew up in a restaurant. And actually, the restaurant I grew up in was a chili parlor. Right? So I'm going to tell you, flatulence is kind of my superpower. Right? I mean, I'm tired of hiding it, okay? I want to let my little light shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. If it's an open flame and it's about ass level, that little light is gonna burn this motherfucker down. Okay, I digress. I don't want to brag. I don't want to make anyone jealous about my superpower, flatulent superpower. Being 50. Back to being 50. It's different for guys and for gals, aging, being 50. We all know there's a lot of difference between guys and gals. And I gotta tell you too, one thing, I'm digressing again, but one thing I actually, one of the biggest difference, like guys, like, okay, nut shots. You know, like those videos, a dude will like, ring the doorbell and they'll see, you know, their buddy or I don't know, somebody they hate and like, boom, you know, nutshot. What the fuck? I don't care how much I don't like some bitch. I'm not gonna like ring her doorbell when she gets there and not gonna like, boom, give her the uppercut. I'll just talk about her and how her hair looks frizzy. You're like, oh my God, those are Buster shoes, right? A lot of different things about aging. For example, hair, right? For guys, all of a sudden, it's like the hair wants you to be proud, right? The hair starts moving and starts going down your back. Even the ear hair starts moving back, right? It's like you're supposed to be proud and show it off because you're fertile. And you're so fertile, right? But ladies, oh my God, all of a sudden, you start like, the hair starts closing in on you, right? Because you're coming all like dried up and like, ooh, you're withering. It's time to just shut down. Yeah, because a 50-year-old dude could like come up on stage right before the show and like beat off and then just like throw the jizz on all over the seats, right? Some fertile young nymph will just come in and sit down wearing a skirt, and that seed will just like crawl right up there, and boom, you know, 9 months later, she's pregnant with a baby, right? 50-year-old lady sits on that same seat, it'll just like wither up, like it's in the desert. Just all the moisture sucking on dust. Which is actually good, okay? I'm 50, I'm single, I've never had children, okay? I know I probably said this a lot, but one of the reasons my mother, my sweet mother, who I love so dearly, when I was a wee lass, she said, you know, Christy, honey, if you ever get pregnant, I will hold your hand during the abortion. Sweet lady, sweet, sweet lady. Just a couple more things here, just a couple more things. Oh yeah, okay, you know, speaking of like jizz, speaking of the sex stuff, okay? The other thing, ladies, well even, I guess guys too, you know, the one thing I'm gonna tell you, don't give a blowjob to a feller unless you really trust him. Okay, I'll tell you, because at 50, for me, my knees are really hard, and like, you know, when you're trying to get up, it could take a few minutes, right? And you don't want some jerk who's just gonna like try and stick it right in there again, just try and get like a quick little second one. So make sure you really trust whoever you give a BJ to, right? And my last bit of advice here, okay? If you think you sharted, you didn't. You know when you shart. You know it. Thanks, you guys. I'm Christy McKay.